Hello, welcome back to Pediatric Survival Swim. My name is Allison Hogue. I'm a survival swimming specialist here in Riverview, Florida, and the purpose of my channel is to create content and education to share with parents to let them know about the number one cause of unintentional death in children under the age of 5 and the second leading cause of unintentional death in children ages 5 to 15. So today for my video, I wanted to talk about children with special needs. Now, lots of people are kind of hesitant when it comes to children with special needs and swim lessons, especially group lessons or survival swimming lessons. And I can understand that. And I certainly have had my fair share of students that have had special needs or learning disabilities. And I can tell you from experience that it can be done. Many, many children thrive in the water with special needs, without special needs. There are many different reasons for that that we're going to touch base on as well. But the purpose of my video is to really help you decide for your family if survival swimming instruction is the best option for you and your family, and how to go about finding an instructor for your child if he or she has special needs or has a learning disability. So with that being said, let's get started. I always highly, highly recommend a private instructor if possible. I not only recommend this for children who have learning disabilities and special needs, but for anyone at all, any child, private one-on-one instruction is just the way to go. You get the best results, the fastest results. And then later, after they've mastered that skill, that survival swimming instruction and skill, then you can always move on to a team sport or another group lesson to help develop different kinds of swimming strokes. So I do recommend that. Now, I do understand that depending on your region, depending on where you live, that survival swimming instruction or even private instruction may not be available to you. But hopefully with a few of these tips, it will help you decide what the best instructor might be for you and for your family. So for me personally, I would recommend private one-on-one survival swimming instruction over a group instruction. And that is because I always like to focus just on one child at a time, really contouring to that child and what they need specifically, and being able to change it up a little bit for that child to really help them thrive and master that skill is very important, and that's very hard to do in a group setting. Also, I never like to turn my back to a child at all in the water. I like to have all eyes on. So for me personally, one-on-one instruction is just the best way to go. The parent is watching the child. I myself have hands-on and am watching the child. The child never leaves my side. So group instruction doesn't always provide that. And that's just something that I personally don't care for. But if that's your only option, then swim lessons are better than none at all. Just make sure you, the parent, are always poolside, very close, keeping your eyes on your child at all times, because there may only be one instructor. Hopefully there are two, where you can have an instructor watching all the children and the other working one-on-one. Now, with a group instruction, you are not going to get your lesson maybe 30 minutes long, an hour long, however long, but your child is not going to get all that instruction for that class. So it will be broken up, you know, evenly and divided by however many students you have. Now, there can be benefits to group classes. I like to think of the water as balancing out and making classes more of an even playing field, because children approach the water differently. Every child is special and independent and different in many ways, and how they approach the water is very different from one student to another. If you have a child that is fearful of the water, they're going to respond differently than a child that's been in the water since they were a baby or who lives in Florida versus who lives in a climate that whose, you know, swim seasons are much shorter and they're not quite used to being submerged in the water or being, you know, cold or hot all the time. So every child is different, and you can also watch your child gain experiences and learn from other children as well. So there can be pros and cons to group instruction versus private instruction, but me personally, I will always do private instruction. That's just the way I was trained, the way I'm wired, and that's what I prefer. So, survival swimming instruction or any kind of water instruction can really improve the mobility of a child, the balance. Sometimes it helps you overcome some limitations that you have outside of the water. So really a great exercise, physical activity, and we like that. It's very, research has shown that it's very brain stimulating as well. You have to, learning the survival swimming techniques, you have to use both sides of your brain. So it's very great for cognitive development as well. And then it builds confidence. It does. It builds confidence and your self accomplishment. You feel great once your child has mastered a skill. You go celebrate. You know, everyone's so excited. For me, I give out goodie bags and stickers and tattoos and all that stuff to let my children know that they've done a great, great job. Now, when looking for a survival swimming instructor or just a water instructor, period, you may be limited to your options depending on your region, like I said. But if you happen to live in a place where you have lots of options, like me in Florida, I always suggest a survival swimming instructor, an instructor that has more of an educational background, like myself. My bachelor's degree is in early childhood education. Before I was a water instructor, I was a public school teacher, private school teacher, middle school teacher. I've dabbled in everything, and I also have lots of experience with children with special needs. So you want to try to find an instructor. If your child has a learning disability or special needs, try to find somebody that has had experience in that field. Even if it's not in swimming, if it's in the education field, that's, you know, could be just as good because they understand how to appropriately work with that child. And again, that's kind of why I lean more towards private instruction when I'm referring people versus group instruction, because you're more likely to find an instructor that has experience in that area. Also, when your child has special needs or a learning disability, or really any child that has seen a specialist, I always have them a pediatrician sign off that they can have swim lessons. And then if they are currently seeing a specialist, I would like for the specialist as well to sign off saying that we have cleared this child for swim lessons. And then that way I know that there's not going to be any medical mishaps that I have to be looking out for. Of course, there are always children that are going to have allergies, children that are prone to seizures and that sort of thing. So definitely, definitely be aware of that. And make sure that your instructor has lots of knowledge on that as well. And communication is key. You don't ever want to leave anything out with a swim instructor. If your child's been sick, you need to tell them. If your child has had different or loose bowel movements, you may think it doesn't apply, it's not applicable, but it is. We need to know how much water they're taking in, and sometimes diapers can be a result of that. It can really tell us a lot about your child and how they're doing in our classes. So that's important. If your child, or I'm sorry, if you do not find an instructor that has experience with children with special needs, then go interview. Go interview some people and find an instructor that has a great demeanor, that's going to be best suited personality-wise for your child. Not every child and instructor really fit together. And just like every teacher and student in their classroom may not always fit together, may butt heads, and that's okay. But you want to find an instructor that your student is comfortable with, or that your student could get comfortable with in the future. Ask for a free trial lesson. I always invite my potential clients to come and watch a few lessons, and then when your student is comfortable or you are comfortable presenting me with your child, then we will get in and we will do a trial lesson. There's nothing wrong with testing out a product before you buy it. I highly recommend it. That way you get more of a feel for what you're going to be paying for, what the instructor is going to be providing, and how your child is going to react. Now, survival swimming lessons can make some children fearful of the water at first because the instructor is providing, is asking the child to do something that has not been required of them before. Therefore, they're scared and they don't understand. So sometimes the first lesson, at first, second, and third lesson may be the very hardest. So you're going to have to decide after that first or second lesson if that's something that you want to continue. And I highly recommend that you do, because usually after the first week or two, your child knows the expectation and is starting to gain confidence and mastery and a few of those techniques. And so they calm down, they settle down, and then by the end they really start to enjoy the water, and you are provided with a life-saving skill that you can, you know, watch your child do throughout the rest of his life. And something that really really gives you peace of mind as well. As for me, I always recommend an instructor that is going to teach you, the parent, how to gain that skill from the child, get that skill from the child once the course is over and the skill has been mastered. Some instructors don't do this. I always, always, always do this. I always offer it. Grandparents can come, parents can come, whoever is with the child the most, come into the water with me, whoever's going to be taking them to the pool. Once we have finished the course and I know confidently that your child has checked out in the survival swimming test, then I will invite the adults in. And we will have some fun. We will do some play, and you will be able to learn how to get that skill from the child so that you can go off and practice on your own. You also want to communicate very well with that instructor that your child has special needs or a learning disability and that it may take more time. This also may mean that your child may need more refreshers more often than other children, to make sure that that skill is always on point and that it's always well maintained, so that if there's ever a fall in at a pool or a lake, that your child will know how to survive that fall in and roll to a float and hold it, or wait for help, or is able to successfully get out of the pool by his or herself. So hopefully these are some tips that you can take away and apply to you and your family and your child. And please feel free to like this video, share this video, and follow our YouTube channel. We are providing education all across the world to parents and letting them know that drowning is something, even in colder regions, that you still have to be aware of, and it's very preventable, and that's why we're here, to provide education to help combat the leading cause of death in children under the age of 5 and second leading cause of death of children ages 5 to 15. So please leave a comment below if you have any questions or concerns. Go find us on Facebook. Like our Facebook page. We post most of our content there, and I'm currently doing a promotion through Sunday, and that is liking our Facebook page, sharing the information that I have on our post, and commenting and nominating a child of your choice. And there's no limit on how many times a child can be nominated. And by the end of this week, I'm going to pick a winner for a free survival swimming course. Absolutely free. Your child will learn survival swimming instruction, how to survive a water and aquatic fall-ins. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Allison Ho with Pediatric Survival Swim, and I will see you next time.